Peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Today, let us reflect on the gospel according to Luke chapter 4, verses 16 to 30. Jesus rejected at Nazareth. When he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom. He stood up to read. And the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendant, and sat down. The eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to say to them, "Today, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." All spoke well of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They said, "Is not this Joseph's son?" He said to them, "Doubtless you will quote to me this proverb, 'Doctor, cure yourself,' and you will say, 'Do here also in your hometown the things that we have heard you did at Capernaum.' And he said, 'Truly, I tell you, no prophet is accepted in the prophet's hometown. But the truth is, there were many widows in Israel in the time of Elijah, when the heaven was shut up for 3 years and 6 months, and there was a severe famine over all the land. Yet Elijah was sent to none of them except to a widow at Zarephath in Sidon. There were also many lepers in Israel in the time of the prophet Elisha, and none of them was cleansed except Naaman the Syrian." When they heard this, all in the synagogue were filled with rage. They got up, drove him out of the town, and led him to the brow of the hill on which their town was built, so that they might hurl him off the cliff. But he passed through the midst of them and went on his way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. My dear brothers and sisters, the very title of this passage of scripture says, "Jesus rejected at Nazareth." Now, if we look at the Gospel of Luke, we see how Jesus, after he has been baptized, he has been in the wilderness, and he began his public ministry. He went about doing good. And when he came to his own hometown, the hometown of Nazareth, and he went to the synagogue, we see that the scroll that was given to him was from the prophet Isaiah. Now, whatever he read and is recorded in Luke 4, 18. Now, this is from Isaiah 61. "So the Lord read that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, and to let the oppressed go free." Now, this was the prophecy of Isaiah about the coming Messiah. And when Jesus reads this, he speaks, and he continues only up to Luke 4:19, wherein it says to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. But if we look in the book of Isaiah, it also has the Isaiah 61 verses 2 speaks of to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God. But when Jesus reads from the scroll, he ends it, the year of the Lord's favor. Now, when Jesus came to planet Earth, in his first coming, he came to redeem this world. He came to save the world. He came to bring about the favor of Lord of God upon this upon each one of us. So he did not come with vengeance. And because he had come to speak of, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor, Jesus stops at Isaiah 61 verses 2 midway through that scripture. He rolls it up and he gives it back. And then we read that all eyes were fixed on him. And when he continues, what does he say? He says, today the scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing. So when he claims that, in other words, he means that he is the one who's the anointed one, upon whom the Spirit of the Lord is, who has been sent to bring the good news to the poor. The news about the favor of God. He is the one who's sent to release the captives, the ones who are oppressed, the ones who are under the oppression of sin, oppression of demonic work. He has been the one who has been sent. He's the one who's sent for the recovery of the blind. Now, this recovery of sight is not just the physical sight, but it is also for the recovery of the spiritual eyes to be opened. So when he says that and he claims it, that today this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing, he's telling them that he is the Messiah. And as he speaks, the people around him, the word of God tells us that all spoke well of him. So it further says they spoke well of him. And on the other side, they say they were amazed at the gracious words. But as the word of God says that they were amazed or they marveled, we see that they also said, is not this Joseph's son? So it is something which sounds like, from where is all this coming? So they're looking at Jesus in the physical as a son of a carpenter, and they're marveling at how he has all of this wisdom. And to that, the Lord says, doubtless, he knows what is going on in their heart. He knows the intent of their heart. So the Lord himself says, you will say, do here whatever you did in Capernaum. And the Lord tells them that no prophet is accepted in their own hometown. Now, Nazareth was Jesus' hometown, but he was not accepted in his own hometown by the very fact that they said, is he not Joseph's son? So they are questioning from where he's speaking. When Jesus is speaking about no prophet is accepted in the prophet's hometown, he gives two accounts from the Old Testament. If we look at Elijah, now Elijah was sent to a widow in Zarephath in Sidon. Now Sidon was a Gentile city. So Elijah the prophet was sent to a place which was not the Jewish land, but it was a Gentile area at the time of the famine, when there were so many who were without food and there were so many widows, but he was sent to a Gentile area. We also see Jesus mentioning about Elisha, the prophet, who cleansed Naaman, who was a leper. And this official was of the Syrian army. So he was also from a Gentile area. So when Jesus was citing these examples of prophets who were sent to areas which were other than the place that they were in. The Lord is conveying to them that a prophet is not accepted in their own hometown. He's showing them from the Old Testament instances, right up to his time, that a person who comes in the name of the Lord is not accepted in his own hometown. My dear brothers and sisters, there could be times that when you read this scripture passage, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Now, at the time that Jesus read it, he said that the scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing. Jesus came on planet Earth with a mission. And this mission of the Lord has now been given to us. Each one of us have been anointed by the Holy Spirit through our baptism. We are anointed to bring the good news to the poor. We are anointed to proclaim release to the captives, the recovery of sight to the blind, to allow the oppressed to go free. But oftentimes, when we do, you and I may find that we are not accepted within our own communities. We are not accepted within the place that we start. Let us not be discouraged. Jesus was rejected in his own hometown. Let us be empowered by the Holy Spirit to take this message of the gospel of Christ to the ends of the world, that whoever is led by the Spirit of God receives it, because the gospel of Christ is the power of God for salvation. So we see that as he spoke, earlier we saw that all of them spoke well of him. They were amazed, they were marveled. And as he speaks further, they are filled with rage. The very people who spoke well of him are now filled with rage, that they got up to throw him from the hill. Jesus was almost killed. The rejection of the Lord was to an extent that they aimed to kill him. But the Lord had to go to the cross. Definitely, he came on planet Earth to give up his life for the salvation of men. But his death was not meant to be by being just thrown down the cliff. So at that point in time, he escaped. He just passed through the midst of them and he went on his way. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, let us know that this anointing which was upon Jesus is the same anointing that is upon each one of us. Let us open the eyes of our mind, open our hearts, and be empowered to go out proclaiming the good news of the gospel of Christ. Because the Lord himself spoke that this is being fulfilled in your hearing. Do you also believe that in your hearing of this scripture today, that this scripture is being fulfilled? We know in Luke chapter 1, when Elizabeth is visited by Mother Mary, what does she say to Mother Mary? She says, "Blessed are you who has believed that there will be a fulfillment of what God has promised, of what the Lord has spoken." So my dear brothers and sisters, the same applies to each one of us. Blessed are we who believe that the scripture has been fulfilled in our hearing and is stepping out in faith with our action corresponding to the message that we have just received. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Let us close with a thanksgiving prayer. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God, our loving Father, we thank you, we praise you, we give you glory. Thank you, Father, for sending your beloved Son, Lord Jesus Christ, who, empowered by the Holy Spirit, went about doing good. Thank you, Lord, that we too have been anointed by the Holy Spirit from our baptism. Help us to acknowledge that we have a mission which is given to us, a mission to go out proclaiming the year of the Lord's favor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are a spirit of boldness. Thank you, Lord, that we step out with the boldness to proclaim the gospel of the Savior, the gospel of Christ. Thank you, Jesus, that through these actions, souls are saved for your kingdom. We make this prayer in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, for joining in today. I'll see you again on Wednesday. Have a blessed day. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
If any one of you would want me to add you to the group, WhatsApp group, you can just leave your name and number in the chat, then I can add you. Do share these videos on the daily reflection and subscribe to the channel. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God.
Thank you.